Okay guys, today we're joined by Big G, who some of you might know as the captain of SC Dons, one of the biggest football clubs on YouTube. In this video, he's going to give you some great advice on how you can make it as a professional footballer.
My little cousin SK, he was at Millwall, he was at Leighton Orient, he was at Swindon at the time. And I was having to ask him, like, how do you play football basically? Like, what are you being taught? What do I need to know? Because if you don't have the answers, you've got to ask people. If you've got friends who are professionals or playing at a good standard, you've got to ask them the question, what are they being taught? What is it expected of them at that level? So I would ask SK, like, you're a defender. How do they set up? How do you play out from the back? How do you deal with long balls into the box? And I'd be looking on YouTube and I'd be doing all that stuff. So if I'm a young player, I'd be thinking, right, we got told this at the Nike Academy. What is your 10 out of 10? Like, what is that one thing that you can rely on solely in every game to be your 10 out of 10? Because that will be your base of everything else you do. So once you know what you're good at, you play to that, and then you balance off in the other areas. So if another area is, let's say, a 10 out of 10, the other areas that could be threes or fours need to be a 5, 6, 7, so that it balances your overall game. So you have to know your own game and what's required from what you do in that team. And then the other side to it is the game management. Everyone's the best coach, critique, football analyzer when a game's done. When a game's going on, like, that's the hardest bit. And I remember I had this manager, Matt Longhurst. He used to say, fucking hell, George, you're fucking brilliant when the game's going that way away from you. What about when it's coming back towards you? And then it made me ask, right, cool. So it's easy to scream, squeeze up, But what about when you've got players running from one side of the pitch across your centre half? Are you telling him left shoulder, drop with him, squeeze up, hold the line? Are you assessing the game as it's going on while you're in there? Which is, again, why you have to understand what are you looking for. And I think a lot of players don't know how to self-assess their actual performance and how to manage a game of football. Now, when you're playing Sunday League football, everyone goes, oh, that's Sunday League defending. It's because the games can be so erratic. But how do you control a game of football? How do you, in your position, affect the game so that it is a strength to what you're good at and it's a strength to your team? In my own way, I was always earning other people's respect because I believed in myself that as long as I work hard, which is what my dad always say, you can't work hard and you don't get nothing out of it. It's impossible. So if I'm a young player coming up, I would say to them, don't see every no as an opportunity to quit. See it as a challenge for yourself. So young players, understand that it's, especially if you want to become a professional here in England, it's tough. Don't be afraid to go abroad. So open up your life experiences and use whatever networks you have.